I think my most enduring memory of the Transformers movie from 1986 is that I watched a VHS tape of that over and over and over again because we recorded it off of the television. I think it was the midday movie. We actually missed the first few minutes of it because we were trying to find an appropriate tape to record it. I think I wore that tape out. So for the longest time, I actually forgot what the opening few minutes of the movie were. Until many years later, when it was finally released on DVD. And so this year, this week actually, if I upload this in time, is the 35th anniversary of the Transformers the movie. And I want to celebrate by opening some toys, some brand new toys actually. When I started collecting Transformers again, I had three criteria. Pretty much recreate my childhood collection, which I reckon I'm pretty much done on that one. The other one was collect Beast Wars anything. Beast Wars was what got me back onto Transformers back then. The third criteria was to recreate the cast of the 1986 film. Unfortunately, I didn't quite get there. I've sort of given up purchasing G1, or at least hunting them down, because quite honestly, I can't justify paying those prices for anything complete or in decent condition. However, the goal of recreating the 86 cast is still there. I will admit, I originally wasn't that interested in buying the War for Cybertron stuff. I was initially put off by not only the previous incarnations, the Titans Return and the Power of the Prime stuff, but also the really hack job they did on the battle damage. Yeah, that was sort of very gimmicky and it didn't work for me. However, I was brought around when the 86 Studio Series was brought out, and I thought, okay, I see what you're trying to do now. And that's where I saw the potential of carrying out that third Transformers collecting goal that I set out for myself. And yeah. My Transformers shelf got a bit of an upgrade in recent months as well. That was a year after it got its other previous upgrade and rearrangement. So there's now more space and I can actually display the 86 cast. So let's get started on that. So I was originally put off by the Siege line of War for Cybertron toys, primarily because the gimmicky weathering and battle damage was, it wasn't good. I kind of regret that only in one instance, but not anymore. I was able to rectify that, so I've only got one Transformer from the Siege line. And he's loose as well, because that was the only way I could get him at an affordable price now that he wasn't available locally anymore. The Siege version, it's the only version of Springer they released for the War for Cybertron toy line. Well, that's his helicopter mode, isn't it? So let's get his propeller out. And that's actually pretty cool. So yeah. That's nice. That's it's fine. I've always found that Transformers have had this trade-off. Either you get a really cool robot or a really accurate, excellent vehicle. You rarely ever get both unless you... arguably, unless you went with a masterpiece version. If I'm honest, they did a very good job in making the robots, at the very least, making the robots look like the characters. Most of them, anyway. This might take a while. I've got the instructions in front of me, but I'm partially winging it because I'm that stupid, maybe? Put that on your back, and then let's put that over here. That's not bad. If you can ignore the fact that it looks like someone's gone at it with a silver Sharpie. It looks like he's sort of stepped out of the 86 film, or at least a nice interpretation of it. They'd never have to look like they were hand-drawn. They'd never have to look exactly like the cartoon. For me, the wish list is more a case of, you know, if they have the same silhouette, character design-wise, but he's a nice one to start off with. Like I said, this is... Well, actually, I'll correct myself. Technically, this is the only Siege toy that I bought. There's the other one is the Netflix Megatron. It's the Siege version, but it's the Netflix special release. I got it anyway because it was cheap. Whether or not I open that is another matter altogether, because I sort of want his Earth mode, which I actually finally found. So happy with that. We'll move him to the side there. And another loose one. Bought from the same seller. Bought him for cheap. It was, you know, it was better off just to get them at the same time because I didn't need him brand new. He's complete, he's got his instructions as well. Earthrise Astro Train. He's not really that different from the Siege version of Astro Train. I'm not sure why they released the same toy twice. There might be a difference in how much silver Sharpie they went over it with. But other than that, I thought, well, you know, might as well get him as well. He features prominently in one scene in the movie, even though he's not main cast. Also, I think I did a tally and I think I needed more Decepticons. Anyway, so there's two down. There's actually one more I opened, but I think I'm going to leave him till last. Let's actually open up one of the boxes. Next up, let's do Starscream. Hey! Let's go right into it. There's Starscream. And again, character silhouette looks fantastic. I can only go by the box. The jet, well, they photographed him in a way that makes it look like the jet's pretty cool. Yeah, and there's a gimmick with the boxes, I get that. Let's be realistic, no one cares. Well, that's all fair. It's a nice little gimmick for kids. What the hell? Let's see how we go. That is so stupid. Flip. Whatever. That's actually not terrible if you only look at the top of it. The bottom of it, he is pretty much squished in, so I'll allow it. His robot mode is excellent, I think. It's a nice sort of interpretation of the G1 look. That works for me. I will admit my favorite Starscream is actually the Fall of Cybertron version. I'm a massive fan of the War for Cybertron video games. That was like 10 years ago now, and when they recycled the branding for these toys, I will admit I was a little miffed at first, but you know what? Business is business, I guess. There's that fella there. You know what? Well, let's do Megatron. I was debating whether or not to bother with the Earthrise one because I had already got the Netflix one, which is based on the Siege toy repainted. So not premium finish, which I got to admit, those premium finish toys don't look very premium finish according to the photos they've shown us. But because at one point I was contemplating having the sort of the really intense battle damage version of Megatron to represent, well, after that big fight with Optimus, infamously killing off all the old popular characters to sell new toys. Speaking of which, I almost got put off buying some of these toys, mainly because the War for Cybertron Netflix series is kind of rubbish. By the time this video goes up, hopefully I've got my post-mortem written up on my blog. Not so much a review, but more of an autopsy, I guess. I didn't enjoy it. I'm not going to go into it here. The reason why I'm opening these up now is because I wanted to save it for an occasion like this. And in fact, I wanted to wait until I had the complete cast. I kind of knew what I was getting into with these toys. I bought the loose ones. I actually opened up one of them last year, and we'll get to him later. I've been very patient. I've also been very aggravated as well, chasing some of these things down. When you think about how Hasbro do things, and you combine that with the pandemic, of course, and how stock can't quite get to places properly. I live in Adelaide, South Australia, and so we don't get as much stock as our eastern state counterparts. So when the scalpers are out there, they bloody take it all. So yeah, you know what? I'm playing around with this guy, but he's got some loose joints. Yeah, look, he's looking very G1, apart from the fact that he doesn't turn into a gun. And that's fine. I prefer that he turns into a tank. He reminds me, actually another one of the toys reminds me of Transformers Devastation video game. That was a fantastic video game. Megatron turns into a tank, so... Oops, I forgot to put his cannon on. Holy shit, forgot which arm this goes on. I'll show it to this camera. That's actually pretty nice. They're very backpack heavy, aren't they? But I like the look of him. He's kind of cool. So, we've done one of the new cast. Let's get this one in. RC. I have a false memory about there being an RC toy when I was little. I must have been confusing it with something else, but yeah, apparently there was never an RC toy, which, you know, a bit disappointing. I have the other one that everyone's comparing this one to, and it's really cool, but I kind of want to match the scale of the other toys. I like consistency, really. Oh, come on. Wow, that is a giant backpack. Wait, I thought it came off. Huh, the gun is translucent. Yeah, that backpack is shocking. It's no better than the other one, but honestly, look, I don't mind it. It's a lot, really. Yeah, look, I think for the sake of this part of the video, I'm not going to do transformations. I mean, really, in all honesty, I'm not going to pose them in their alt forms. I mean, I'm usually an action figure guy anyway, and a lot of the stuff I have, they're displayed, well, they're action figures, so they only have one mode. This has got to tell me how to detach that. It came off. I mean, you know what? Turning it into a platform that she can surf or skate on, it's not a terrible gimmick. I don't particularly hate that idea. It's better than Optimus's trailer disappearing. Your mileage may vary, obviously, but I don't hate that at all. Let's put her over there. I stuck the receipt in this one. Next one is Cliff Jumper. Not a huge role in the movie. Came from the series, but they didn't kill him off. He did survive the attack on the moon base. Did he? Yeah. Oh, okay. I mean, I'm assuming that I'm speeding up most of this or just cutting out most of this in post, so... There we go. Oh, he is tiny for how much of a box there is. Oh, he has a backpack. That's not a terrible backpack. You know what? I wonder if I can do this without the instructions. I did bring them out, but... No, did I guess that? No. Oh wow, that is quite a tidy little car. Oop, not everything's in place, but oh wow. I'm a little impressed with that. Let's try over here. Yeah, there you go, look at that. That's not bad. That's pretty schmick. Then he's got this massive gun that they've just given him. Is Cliff Jumper really compensating? Like, holy crap. There you go. Not too shabby at all. He's kind of cool. Again, not a main new character, but he was going for cheap, so I thought, why not? But speaking of Cliff Jumper and Moon Base 1, Yeah. Let's maybe get on to someone else that was with him. Let's move on to Studio Series. Jazz. Again, I will reiterate, when you look at the 86 Studio Series and then at the War for Cybertron stuff, there does seem to be this very clear intent that they want to reach for the movie nostalgia. So we got a backdrop there. That's actually really cool. It is the view from their moon base. So yeah, I like that. Probably not going to use it. I appreciate it all the same. Yeah, you know what? For all the cynicism I have about some of these toys, and for, you know, certain companies and the way they do things, I will always appreciate a little extra effort at a reasonable price. The deluxe toys, I would always get them, or most of them, from Kmart, because they were the cheapest. I get Kmart here in Australia, I'm talking about, obviously. Occasionally, if they get the Voyager classes as well, because they're always cheaper. That was one of my other frustrations with collecting Transformers, or new Transformers again. There's this very bizarre way they do things in regards to which retailer gets what toy and when they get them. So just the uncertainty of which retailer is getting what fueled the toy anxiety, which I never really had before. So yeah, Jazz has got a lot of hollow sections in him, but front on, the silhouette's not too bad. Yeah, there we go. It's not bad. I don't necessarily need him to be perfect or anything like that. Yeah, just looking back here, he's got a lot of hollow components. I mean, that's why there's a lot of third-party accessories to attach onto him and things like that, but yeah. Jazz Cliff Jumper! Moving on to the new cast, and we've got Blur. So Blur is one of the toys that I actually did have as a kid. Oh wow, that is a very nice depiction of Autobot City. And that's when the Decepticons were attacking towards the beginning of the film. Here's a question. Autobot City being placed on Earth, how do you think the governments of Earth reacted to that? We're not talking about it's a cartoon, it doesn't matter. Just imagine trying to reinterpret that film into modern day and like in live action. And then you have to deal with, oh yeah, all the Earth governments have to agree to allow up a lot of their land to these aliens. That just would never happen, would it? Actually, what was I saying before? Oh yeah, out of my childhood G1 collection, Blur was one of the toys that I had, and in recent years I was able to replace it with a inexpensive one. I think I paid about $20 for him. He didn't have his gun. No gun, but he did have that component that's like a shield, and it wasn't broken, which is always a bonus. But then I found my childhood one amongst some hidden toys, and oops, did I miss out something? Oh. Yeah, I left something in the box. Oh, wow. Talking away and not paying attention. Oh! So there's Blur, looking, you know, pretty cool. He's got a bit of... He's not bad in terms of the hollow plastic. He's got these large things on the back of his arms. Not ideal, but... You know, I think the G1 toy did a better job of trying to hide those sort of elements. That's not bad. However, I'll show you this little doohickey. So hopefully you can see it on there. That's the welding device that he has when they're on the planet of junk and they're trying to repair their ship. You know what? It's the simplest of bloody things, but I like that. I like that little extra bit of detail. Alright, so let's put him with the new cast. More of the new cast, and possibly, frustratingly, my least favourite of the new toys. Another 86 Studio Series. It's Cup. So earlier in the year, I did 5 favourite and 5 frustrating toy buys of the previous year. And this Cup, actually ended up at the top of my frustrating list. Now, keep in mind, I didn't say bad, I said frustrating. You know, I could still be frustrated at bad toys, or I could just be simply annoyed, right? For all the other toys that are looking like their animated counterparts, cup here doesn't quite work. There's an attempt, but for some reason, cup is so off the mark. And that's despite things like this. There's the, there's that mechanical squid that tears him apart. Ooh, they really wanted to keep this thing in here, didn't they? Yeah, I look at this toy and I don't quite rate it as highly as the others. It's like, it's not terrible, but for whatever reason, it doesn't quite look the part. The face is off. In my opinion, the colors are off. His silhouette isn't quite there either. It doesn't quite work for me. There are other things that sort of compensate for it. For instance, his legs come off. His limbs come off, sorry. You're meant to emulate when Hot Rod repairs him after being torn apart by that mechanical squid. Oh God, that is, I'm not sure how to call that, but oh well. It's more gimmicky than faithful. Let's put it that way. There's even a small canister of Energon goodies that is included with him. So, like, there's effort with the gimmicks, but not with the figure itself, which I think frustrates me more than anything else. Like I said, it's not terrible, but based on the criteria that the other toys were going by in trying to recreate the 1986 movie characters, he doesn't have hollow plastic like Jazz does, and yet he doesn't feel as substantial. If I transformed him and you know, he looks like the car, he looks like his vehicle mode, maybe that's what they would... I don't know. Part of my frustration probably stems from the fact that the original G1 cup was one of my favorites as a kid. That felt like a substantial toy because he had a die-cast chest. But yeah, it's strange how that one... how I react negatively to this toy. Anyway. Oh well. The final deluxe figure that I have to open is the Alicon. I really regret not getting more of these. But yeah, when I bought this one, I wasn't that, I wasn't 100% certain about doing this yet, or even if I wanted to army build. And so when the Sharktacon is released, I do want to get a few of those. Hopefully they'll be cheap. I think they're Studio Series, aren't they? Yeah. I still have to get a Quintesson. Again, I'm not even sure if that made it to my part of Australia or not. I have to track down an affordable one. It is annoying how once the next wave comes out, they just don't bother with releasing any more of this stuff. And yeah, so that's one of the other annoying things about collecting new Transformers. Alright, there's a spear. And there's an Alicon. Not bad. Is that the first time they've depicted an Alicon as a toy? I know there's a G1 Sharktacon, but I've never seen an Alicon before, so that's very cool. Oh, that is a cheat. His head's on the back, but if you remember how it transforms in the movie, it's the chest becomes the head. All good. Let's bung him over here. Still got a few of the new cast. Voyager class. I will admit, the different class levels, I've taken a little longer than I should to remember them all, but anyway, here we go with Hot Rod. And yeah, I'm just in the box itself, I'm particularly impressed with how he looks. I'm not going to say he was ever my favorite. Well, this is side here for the time being. I never liked these sorts of characters, and I never had the G1 version when I was a kid. Oh. It is strange that they would include the Matrix for this one here. I guess I get it. If you weren't able to purchase the Kingdom Rodimus, then you can still recreate the iconic moment from the film, especially with that backdrop right there. He's got articulated fingers. I mean, it's all in one lot, but they articulate so that he can hold on to the Matrix. Yeah, very deliberate. He's also got this buzzsaw accessory. I really should invest some time later in transforming him to see how he looks, but that is actually quite nice. That is so ridiculous, but I'm liking it all the same. Oh dear, oh well. But yeah, no, I like that. He's got a lot of accessories for a guy who doesn't need guns. I'm liking this so far. I honestly wish I had all of them, but there's still Wreck-Gar to come. There's Gnaw, the Sharktacon. There are others that haven't been announced, or there's a possibility they may not exist. I'd love an 86 Studio Series Perceptor, for instance. I'd also like a few more Decepticons, I guess. It's very Autobot heavy, or maybe that's just how I'm purchasing things. Speaking of Decepticons, let's move on to 86 Studio Series Scourge. Scourge. He is very cool. I was happy to get this at a decent price too. Ooh. Yeah, again, if you're here to see transformations and stuff, not gonna happen. So what I've been doing is I've been buying them up as they are released. I've been buying them locally as well. I think only a few of them have been ordered online. One was the eBay auction for the loose ones. And another, oh wait, I'm confusing some of the Beast Wars ones as well, because I've been buying them up all at the same time. There we go. Most of these I've been buying locally. I go down to my nearest Kmart, Target, or Big W, or even Meijer, and get them. I've bought a couple of things from Toy World, but yeah, they seem to be one of the more expensive places, depending on which one you're wanting, I'm guessing. There's his background. I don't know, it's not that great, but yeah. There wasn't much to him, if we're perfectly honest. Ooh, okay, that's a nice detail. They've painted his nails. Oh yeah, that's really cool. I really like that. So yeah, he's looking really cool. He's looking very, I don't know, goth, very Vincent Price. He's looking like a Decepticon. Really? So, yeah, it's very cool. Yeah, I like that. He looks like a complex transformation as well. Oh, okay, he does have knee joints. Okay, for all the complaints I had for the other figures that were had loose joints, this one has very stiff joints. I'm here for that. Okay, as far as the 86 Studio Series gimmicks go, it doesn't really have anything except for this nocturnal emission. This thing on the end of his gun. It is what it is. I like this. As a figure, as an action figure, he looks really good. That's a good character silhouette right there. I'm impressed. Legitimately impressed. We're now moving on to the Kingdom range. I gotta admit, the way they spread these things out, how they allocate these across the place, is very peculiar. Cyclonus was part of the Kingdom range. And the Kingdom range does this really, really helpful thing in that it's trying to reduce the amount of plastic in its packaging. Yeah, this is the first Kingdom package that I've opened. All the rest of them, that they're encased in plastic, but here we go. They're all attached to the cardboard, and even the window is much smaller. I mean, one side effect of that is you can't just keep it in box to display because you can hardly see any of it. That's minimizing the amount of disposable plastic being used. So yeah, I kind of congratulate them on that effort. They haven't been doing that with latter releases of the Studio Series. They seem to still be fairly plastic intensive. I'm not an environmentalist, but I'm all for anything that's gonna improve things, quality of life and everything like that. Yes, less plastic, that was actually quite painless. and stiff joints on this fella too. And he's got light piping. I haven't been paying attention to that in all the other characters, but he's got light piping. Oops, no, there's something I'm supposed to take out of here. Gimmick, gimmick, gimmick. Gimmick, gimmick, gimmick.
Remember, we belong to him.
Oh wait, that's the other guy. I'll admit, I'm not sure about the purple, but the fact that they're fairly consistent with it is not terrible. That's not bad. I like that. He's menacing, he's chunky, there's not really any hollow plastic that I can see there. Ah, okay, I gotcha. It's how they packaged him. Right. I see. Yeah, stiff joint, I like that. There we go. Again, he's more lavender than, you know, Decepticon purple. Nothing wrong with that, I'm just saying. I don't think he matches. I watched this the other night to get in the mood for this video. Maybe they did match it properly. However, they are consistent with the lavender, so it's not terrible in that sense. Let's put him over there for now. Whoops. Oh! That's lovely. I got an Optimus Prime card. You know what? That is very 90s, that hologram. It reminds me of the covers of some of our workbooks back in primary school. Snap bracelets. It reminds me of snap bracelets as well. So that's actually most of the smaller Transformers. We've still got the big boys left. I'm going to take a break for a late dinner, and I'm going to come back and open the larger big fellas. Yeah. That was really good end of day sushi. Cheap, discounted, it works. Anyway, where were we up to? Let's go back to the overuse of disposable plastic and open up a couple more 86 Studio Series. We'll start off with Studio Series Grimlock. And this is a leader class, and I gotta be honest, I was really impressed when I saw this for the first time in person. I'm a little disappointed that Wheelie cannot transform. Ooh, it's coming back up on me. But I'm still impressed with Grimlock himself. Oh, of course, that's the backdrop. That's in the Quintesson's courtroom, or at the bottom of the pool. So yeah, that's cool. My favorite version of Grimlock happens to be the Fall of Cybertron version, and I have a couple of those toys. Oh, okay, that's already disappointing. So Wheelie is in a permanent sitting position, so that the whole purpose is it's to recreate that scene when he's riding on Grimlock's back. His elbows have zero articulation. All you can really do is pose the slingshot like that. That's a disappointment with this figure. Considering how much a leader class goes for, I'm glad I got most of these at retail, even if they're, you know, lowest of retail prices. I haven't paid more than retail so far. Yeah, Grimlock has kind of got wings. He is a robust figure. His joints are the right. They're not stiff, but at the same time. Oh, hang on a second. he's missing elbows. It's that thing where it's just There's no elbow, it's because the join is right there. The joints aren't hideously tight, nor are they flopping about the place. Just the look of him is really good. So pretty happy with that so far, just from this. Yeah, that's not bad. I prefer to show these in their robot modes, but Grimlock, I may actually just display him in his dino mode. I think I will learn how to transform this one. Bear with me. Okay, that's a disappointing tale already so far. It goes down there. Flip! Okay. Is he not meant to clip on? Maybe that's the way to go. I don't hate it, but it does frustrate me. Let's put them over there. I may have to go back to putting him in robot mode. I mean, he'll take up less space that way as well. Anyway, here is Dinobot Slug with Daniel Witwicky. This one was actually purchased from Toy World. I remember seeing 3 or 4 of them on the shelf, and all of them, or most of them, the boxes were crushed. This is the least crushed of them all. Even though I'm opening them anyway, when you pay full price for something, you want everything to be perfect, really. If there's a dent in anything, there is... this plastic is making this difficult to come out now because the box was crushed. If something's happened to the box, you get suspicious about how your item was handled, for instance. Was it thrown around? Was it at the bottom of much heavier things? Has the box itself actually protected it from that damage and handling? And this is such a minor thing, but imagine if there was the toy itself. There's some, because of where the plastic was crushed, there's some chipping on the cardboard here. It's not a terrible thing because it's just flimsy cardboard, but imagine if it got crushed enough to damage the toy itself. I haven't been paying attention, so I don't know if any of the other Dinobots are being released. You assume so if they've done 2 already? Okay, he feels less substantial, but still not terrible. And also, if, you know, while we're talking about Slug, and we all know what he was originally called, in the UK and Australia, the term slag means something different. However, in metallurgy, stuff to do with metals, slag is actually a proper term. So another disappointment is that this Daniel figure, bent knees again, permanently bent knees, I should say. Yeah. Not happy about that. His arm just came apart. It's a ball joint, so not really a hassle. Daniel Witwicky didn't travel with these guys. He was with Ultra Magnus. Well, they've got Daniel's face on the box art. He's smiling in there under the dome, but wonder if this is worth transforming on camera. Nah, you know what? I may transform him later and do some B-roll shot that I add in here later. Anyway, close-up look. There's Slug. Not terrible. Not too bad. He's not a toit as Grimlock. But, some of that detail that you can see on the Triceratops there is not terrible. And he's got a shoulder peg, so that you could have a Daniel sitting on his shoulder like that, which I don't think was ever in the film. But you know what? It's fine. Alrighty, 2 of the more recent Kingdom releases in the leader class. I'm going to start with Ultra Magnus. So he didn't get an Earthrise form, but he had a Siege form. Again, Kingdom packaging, minimal plastic. I can really appreciate that. He's held down like that iconic image from Gulliver's Travels. There's a lot here strapping him down. Is that everything? No, there's still more. Jeez. Oh, he is shorter than I anticipated, and there is a lot of rubbish here. It's another Optimus Prime card. Are they meant to be different? For all the praise I was giving for the lack of plastic, there was all these tiny little plastic washers. It looks a bit stumpy there. Wow, his hips ratchet. Not bad, yeah. Tight joints, or tight enough joints. They've really gone with the it's a white Optimus with armor gimmick. Why is that? This one came off easily. Why is this one not? I think he looks so stumpy primarily because this armor is just so chunky. It's like wearing cargo pants that are just massive, and so you look shorter because of it, and you look taller if you wear, you know, slim fit jeans or something like that. Actually, I'm looking at his hands right now, and I'm thinking Hot Rod got articulated fingers so he could hold the Matrix. They haven't afforded that to Magnus here, despite the fact, you know, he did hold the Matrix at one point.
He couldn't open it, but
yeah, this one's a little complex. It's sort of weird how, because of the way his armor is so chunky, the backpack is less noticeable on this guy. But you know what? He's got some light piping on him. I can see through the back of his skull. I like that head sculpt. I don't say this enough about Transformers. We normally talk about head sculpts for 1/6 scale figures or Black Series or Marvel Legends, but yeah, the head sculpts for Magnus here is actually quite nice. Most of them are, I gotta be honest, except for that cup. It should be an easy one to get right for Transformers. They're not trying to get the likeness of a real person. It's underappreciated, I think. When you think about these characters and associate their personalities, you also think about the robot faces sometimes, not necessarily their car modes. Except for Grimlock anyway, because whatever. I'll show the back, just quickly. Backpack, you can see the white Optimus truck bumper under there. That is a really chunky leg. That one I ordered from Toys R Us. The Toys R Us was relaunched a few years ago when the branding got bought out by another Aussie mob. And Toys R Us had that for slightly less than other retail. But it sort of makes up for it for a very cheap flat postage fee, which then allowed me to go, well, if they're doing flat postage, I might as well get some other Transformers while I'm there and save a few dollars. This I was insanely happy to get at the price that I found it for. Kingdom Galvatron. At the time of recording, it's been a month now, I think, since Big W had their mid-year toy sale. And their leader class toys were all half price, which means about $44 Australian. I had already bought Grimlock, I had already bought Magnus. And during the toy sales, I was browsing and I actually got something else, which we'll get to later, but I stumbled upon two of these Galvatrons sitting there. I think it was like the second week of the toy sale and no one had noticed them. I grabbed both, one for myself and one for Chris of SFX Images, because he collects these as well. And they were $44 each, half price. Very happy with that. I've never been a fan of the G1 Galvatron toy. I do have him back there. I've always found him to be a little fugly. And so this, I'm a little more impressed with. Oh wow, he's got the big platform there as well. These fellas have been overcompensating. He looks a little runty. But this one seems to have an accessory that I'm particularly pleased by, and I'm getting ahead of myself. I haven't finished cutting him out yet. Oh, got caught by the tape. Hey, a different one this time. It's Black Arachnia. He's not as runty as Magnus, though, because he hasn't got... He's not a small robot covered in armor. He's not a Power of the Primes gimmick, basically. He's got remnants of little weathering and battle damage, which don't quite make sense. Oh, look, I'm confusing the movie with how he appears in the actual War for Cybertron show. I should really forget that. There's a lot to play with here. I like this one. I really do, but I'm having a fiddly time because things aren't locked in place. Yeah. Locked in place. Yes. Yes. Whoop, wrong purple guy. That's better. That feels more comfortable now. So here's the Matrix on a chain. That's right now, that is my favorite detail. You know what? I'm actually really impressed with his cannon. I mean, I think I might have cannon envy. I like this fella. I may not like the original G1 toy, but I'm liking this one. I'm very impressed. For my money, it's the right shade of purple. Again, the head sculpt, appropriately evil. And the cannon really works for me. It is just this ludicrous, translucent, orange plastic. I mean, it doesn't light up. It should. It's just so ostentatious. And yeah, the proportions work so well for me. I'm going to say minimal backpack on this guy. Very happy with that. And I think it's made even better by the fact that I got him at half price. Yeah, I like that. Before we get to the big one, I kind of want to go through a bit of housekeeping, I guess you can call it, or at least vent some of my frustrations. Soundwave was technically never given an Earthrise release. He had a Siege version, which was shite, but then he had a Netflix exclusive version, which was his Earthrise form. Here in Australia, that was only available at Kmart. And even then, I'm not even sure if it arrived in our Kmart, in my part of the country. So exclusive, limited numbers, and all the scalpers or collectors got to them first. As far as leader class, we only got Megatron and whatever that other jet was called. So that's frustrating, but I do have the Kingdom Core class Soundwave. It's not a great replacement. I'd rather have him to scale with everyone else, but then when you think about it, he turns into a boombox. So this Core class scale, it makes more sense, I guess, but here's me hoping that they actually release 86 Studio Series version of him or something. They also did a Netflix version, which again, exclusive to only one retailer, of Bumblebee, and that was his Earthrise mode as well, I think. So that, again, limited numbers, and I never saw it anywhere. Would love to see if they do another release of that one somewhere. There is the Core class with Spike, but again, that's Core class, so it's tiny. I don't care so much about Prowl, but I would love to get an Earthrise Ironhide. Unfortunately, that is in a two-pack with Prowl, and it's an Amazon exclusive, I think, and the cheapest I ever saw it for was $150 before postage on eBay. I don't think they're doing any more Kingdoms releases or War for Cybertron releases that I'm aware of. I think that might have been it, so the things that they've announced up to this point. At the time of recording, I haven't heard anything yet, but I'm hoping that they do an 86 Studio Series Blaster and Perceptor, for instance. Maybe they're going to do more 86 Studio Series, because clearly they want you to recreate the 1986 film with these toys, because not everything was a Studio Series. Some of these were Kingdom, some of these were Earthrise, and not all of them appeared in the cartoon or the Netflix series anyway. So far, just looking at them right in front of me, just out of shot, they are looking really sweet. I'm really enjoying it. Look, there are probably other characters I'm missing, like the rest of the Dinobots would be great. You know, there's stuff that I still need to hunt down, obviously, but stuff that hasn't been announced yet. That's the That's the thing I'm really curious about. Oh, and yeah, there was absolutely no way that I could shell out, what was it, $800 to $900 Aussie for a HasLab Unicron. No way I was going to be able to do that. I'm sort of glad I didn't. Alright, and now the big boy. I do enjoy the story that's behind this one. Here is Commander Class Rodimus Prime. Not really a favourite toy in the G1 version because, well, it's Space Winnebago, isn't it? But I've been enjoying the photos of Rodimus himself. Interesting story with this one. Again, Big W toy sale. And I spotted this fella in their catalogue. And he was about 30% off. I'm probably never going to get cheaper than that. I'm definitely going to get it. I woke up early for the online portion of the sale, which is a day before the prices take effect in store. I think it was about 6:30 our time. I went to the website, I put it in my cart in order to save postage. I picked the one store that had the click and collect, and it was just slightly out of my way, but I got it, and like within 2 hours, they processed the order. I went down there and I got it. It was sort of weird because like none of my other local Big W's were doing click and collect, just this one that no one really goes to. Yeah, I was very pleased with that. Yeah, strange thing is with the Commander Class, no window, so I can't check it out. I know someone else actually lined up on the morning of the start of the in-store toy sale, and apparently grown adults do run towards the toy aisle at during these times. Like, I was glad I got this the civilized way. I am such a smug git. What's the bet now that this is gonna, you know, because I haven't opened it in time, this is gonna be all broken up. Eh, I fix toys. I'm good. Wow, that trailer takes up a lot of real estate. Right, so that's how he looks in there. I mean, I'm guessing they're trying to make the box as flat as possible, be efficient when it comes to storage and transport. It's another Black Arachnia! I didn't like the Kingdom version of her. Oh, wow. That's a lot. Funny thing is, I'm going to have to transform him. Rodimus is in Hot Rod mode right now. Space Winnebago! Okay. Oh. Wow. Okay. So the back of the Space Winnebago. The flap here has hydraulics. Or looks, it has like...
Probably couldn't hear me for that. Yeah, it has hydraulics in it. So for all the snarky shit I've been saying about engineering these really expensive toys, it's such a small, bloody pointless detail, and yet I'm sort of impressed by it. It's like the goddamn audacity. You've shown your cards early. Let's see who's gonna disappoint me now. Right, so it's to emulate the gun base that he had in the G1 toy. What is preventing this from working properly? But why is it locked in place then? I take it back with the whole engineering thing. Why is it... Okay, you put it out like that. That's his weapons platform. Okay. Alright. That's the best that's gonna be. Ooh! It's either a bag of meth, or it's a whole bunch of greeblies. For a second there, it was looking like a prop from Breaking Bad. The gun. We have black exhaust, I think. So you attach that to the smokestacks. He has a sword for some reason. Sub-Zero ice effect, maybe? Yeah, he's got all these little effects going. And, so a mixed yet positive bag so far. And here we have Hot Rod, not bad. And if we do, can he actually just fit? Yeah. That is so stupid. Like, not bad stupid, he just slots right in there, and he kind of, he locks in. There's, this spring loads to cover up and join. That is ridiculous. I'm enjoying that a little too much. There's your space Winnebago. Alrighty, let's figure out how to transform him, because I don't want him to have the touch. That just sounds weird. Ooh, I'm already appreciating the head sculpt on this one. Okay, that's an interesting solution. So, one of my criticisms, or at least my observations with some of these Transformers, is that their elbows are missing. They have a solution for it. It's a bit of an elegant one. Basically, to have a flap that covers the elbow. And yeah, his hands are articulated. Not only that, his pointing finger is separate. He gets a separate articulated pointing finger. Do you want to know why? Because in the movie, he points when he says, "This is the end of the road, Galvatron." Oh, there it is. Oh, for a second there, I was wondering, where's his matrix? And it is planted right there in his chest. You just have to fold down the panel. So in terms of the overall character design and silhouette, it's there, it's right up there. I don't mind this at all, but the engineering to get him there, that is an absolute bastard of a thing. I don't mind him at all. Like, there is a lot of detail on him. The detail on this guy is a lot better than the extra detail they added to Cup, for instance. So yeah, I'm really liking that head sculpt there. He looks like a prime, I guess, is what I reckon from that. I'll say this, had I paid full price, I don't think I'd be completely happy with this. I'm as satisfied as I am, mainly because I saved so much money. Front on, looks pretty nice. I like that. Wow, his hands are huge. These hands are so big. That's probably the other reason why he's got a separate articulated index fingers. His entire hand cannot fit in the matrix, this tiny matrix that they've put in. It's silly, it's stupid, but I'm doing it. There we go. It works for me, so yeah, more pros and cons, I think, for that one. Yeah, don't mind him at all. For the time being, I've cleared some space on that top shelf there now for this recreation of the 1986 film. Even though I need to be mindful of the ones that are still on the way, I think I might be able to sort out their placings now, so let's deal with that. So I forgot to press record on a later update here, but I think I've got it to a point that I'm satisfied by, for the moment at least. There's going to be a lot of rejiggering and updating as new figures are added to this. Right now, Grimlock, I'm just too lazy to transform him back, but then again, I don't mind him in this form. I may do same to Slug later on. Rodimus, was meant to be the focal point, and he may need another platform or another apple box to stand on back there. I might work with the levels a little bit more. Although, there is one more transformer that I've deliberately left till last that needs to be added up there. There we go. Optimus Prime, Earthrise Optimus Prime. He was the very first toy that I purchased for myself after we came out of the very first lockdown last year. You know, he's a bit of a mixed bag. His the figure itself, the Prime figure itself, fantastic. It's a mini masterpiece toy. The trailer, not bad, but not great either. And it's the only reason why this particular figure costs as much as he did. I've placed Optimus and Megatron on different ends of the display, mainly because I wanted them to be kind of the two ends of the old guard. I wanted to focus on the new cast in the middle, new leaders up the back there, and pretty much everyone else in either side. Pretty happy with this. Like I said, plenty more to fix, but for the time being, for me, this is looking like a wonderful celebration of one of my favorite childhood films.